Shubho Mahasaptami. Greetings to one and all. Bengali Association of South Africa is indeed grateful to revered Swami Swatmaramanandaji Maharaj, who will be giving us a talk on Divine Mother and the significance of Durga Puja. Swami Swatmaramananda is the Swami in charge of the Ramakrishna Center of South Africa, Johannesburg. Swamiji joined the Ramakrishna Mission in 1988 and has been actively involved in the organization's multifarious activities ever since. Let us start today's session by hearing Swamiji's melodious bhajans.
Durga Lakshmi Saraswati Devi Jagannmata
Durga Lakshmi Saraswati Devi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Ma Pahi Jagannmata
Durga Lakshmi Saraswati Devi Jagannmata
Durga Lakshmi Saraswati Devi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata
Devi
Jagannmata
Durga Lakshmi Saraswati Devi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata
Devi Jagannmata Maam Pahi Jagannmata Saraswati Devi Jagannmata
Durga Lakshmi 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 Saraswati Devi Jagannmata Devi Jagannmata Devi Jagannmata
या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मातृरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्यै 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 नमो नमः या देवी सर्वभूतेषु श्रद्धारूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्यै 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 नमो नमः आई शैल रीड ए करिकुलम वीटे or you may call it as your bio data. So now let us go through that. Somebody has given a curriculum vitae. And what is that CV? Responsible for global digital transformation and fast tracking. So that his biodata, he's reading, he's giving all a beautiful biodata here. The second is reduction of global carbon dioxide emission. Then the third special quality of that person is 5 million job restructuring. The fourth one is global hygiene initiatives. Ensured 100% compliance on washing hands. Then leading to collaterally reduction of other communicable diseases. Then the fifth quality or the nature is made global industry shift to work from home, saved exposure and costs. The sixth quality is reduction in global noise pollution by making everyone keep their mouth shut, that is masked. Then the seventh is taught cooking, vegetable shopping, housekeeping to many people. Eighth quality of his is highlighted the importance of governance, adaptability and long-term planning by all sectors. The ninth special quality of that person is spiritual contribution, provided ample time to all egoistic and self-centered people to contemplate on their mortal nature, to face themselves. Then the 10th special quality is provided a big boost to the pharma sectors and brought back small utility stores back into the limelight. And this beautiful curriculum vitae or CV biodata is much, much more greater than that of many CEOs in many companies. And whose CV is this? It is the CV of coronavirus. The COVID-19 CV is this one. Isn't it wonderful? So it has highlighted so many problems we have caused to this nature. So now see reduction in global noise pollution by making everyone keep their mouth shut, masked, how we are troubling the nature. Global hygiene initiative, ensured 100% compliance on washing hands, reduction of global carbon dioxide. So all these are beautiful things which have been brought up by coronavirus. Not only that, now it has made us to go through this virtual or online puja also. See, we did the puja online, isn't it? Would that be possible without coronavirus? So it has done so many things. Now, see, we have disturbed the nature in so many ways. Let us see on how can we connect this to Divine Mother. Once Albert Einstein was asked as to what is the important question that the man has to answer. What is the important question that the man has to answer? To which Albert Einstein replied. What did he reply? He replied, is the universe a friendly place or not? He saw man weeping and wailing under the stress of the nature. Perhaps he thought, will the further advancement in science with the selfish nature of man leave this world to remain a friendly place at all? That was the idea behind. Why did he tell that, is the universe a friendly place or not? He saw man weeping and wailing under the stress of the nature. Perhaps he thought, will the further advancement in science and so much of technology and so much of consumerism, so will the further advancement in science with the selfish nature of man, that is very important, leave this world to remain a friendly place at all? With the growing knowledge of science and technology today, man is not only able to utilize some of the forces of nature and provide himself with various amenities of life, but also has gained sufficient capacity to destroy himself and the planet on which he lives. Yet the scientists whisper a note of hope that the human species is passing through the process of an actual transformation from Homo sapiens, that is man of knowledge, to Homo noeticus. What is meant by Homo noeticus? Man of intuition. Knowledge here means the understanding through sense perception or through reasoning. Intuition, on the other hand, is direct perception of the information beyond senses and intellect that is not limited by present perception. So this coronavirus has made us to think of what is our strength, what is our limitation, and to go beyond the senses, to go beyond the intellect, and not limited by present perception. Previous knowledge, belief, space or time, if we happen to examine the power of prayer, meditation, faith, etc., we can come in touch with this truth much expansive and richer than the modern science can pose. Perhaps then we remain tuned to the oneness that is underlying all diversities. So this great coronavirus has made us turn inwards and see what are we going to gain if we go deeper into our own self. But a man who has discovered the nature to be a mother, if we now think the nature, mother, nature as mother, see, in the Western concept is they will always tell fatherland, but in India it is called as motherland. So a man who has discovered the nature to be a mother can derive a million times greater friendly place than what we are doing with this wanton disturbance of the nature with our science and knowledge of technology. So if we start discovering this nature as our mother, then we can derive a million times greater friendly place, a place to comfortably strive, to successfully attain, and to peacefully rest. The thing is, how much of our potential do we invest? That is very, very important. It's beyond doubt that whatever life people generally live, whether physical, moral, intellectual, or spiritual, they live in a very partial or insignificant circle of their potential being. They make use of a very small portion of their possible capacity, possible consciousness. Like a man with his whole body at this disposal, is in habit of moving only his little finger. I'll repeat it again. Like a man with his whole body at his disposal, the man has his whole body, his brain and everything to function. But he feels with his habit, he is in habit of moving only his little finger. So, just to think of this nature as a non-living entity and just disturb it like this is just like using very small finger when we can use the whole body to do that work. So we have not at all harnessed that mother nature in a proper way. So that's why, like a man with his whole body at his disposal is in the habit of moving only his little finger, we possess huge, inexhaustible store of life energy and spiritual power to draw upon, of which we do not even dream. We do not even have the idea of how much energy do we have, but the nature has provided us. What tremendous achievement it could be if we can learn to draw energy and strength from this source. This storehouse is the Divine Mother within us in her aspect as Shakti. That's why you could see in the puja, we try to invoke her in our own heart, the Divine Mother. So what tremendous achievement it could be if we can learn how to draw this energy, strength from the source itself. And who is the source? The storehouse. The source is the Divine Mother. People call in India as Durga. Within us, she is within us. In her aspect of Shakti, the power. So much of power is there within us. Now, we'll come to Navaratri. We have this 9 dark nights. To cross over that is called Navaratri. So thinking of Mother Durga, worshipping Mother Durga, and understanding her in the right perspective, worshipping her, then we can cross over that difficult 9 nights. So to do that vrata, by praising her, by doing her puja, understanding her better, meditating on her, now we'll be crossing over that 9 difficult nights. So that is Navaratri. I have explained that. I will give you a little more explanation of that Navaratri and we'll go forward. Each dark night we recognize to be entangling us. And the challenges of the misfortunes death, destruction and the diseases we face because of the wrong deeds we are doing, the wrong karmas, must help us to re-evaluate our paradigm. For a man, for a sadhaka, anybody for that sake, he may be a spiritual aspirant, he may be ordinary man, wants to enjoy this world, anybody for that sake, initiated into the awareness of existence and presence of the Divine Mother within his heart and also without, everywhere in this universe, each choice of life, that is a crisis, would help him to skillfully lead himself to a rebirth. Now, because we are learning from this pandemic, we should have a rebirth, we should have to think, what did we do now? How we have to change our attitude? So we are going to have a rebirth now. Each rebirth is a new bright day. So every day in the Navaratri, every day we are going to have, every night or every Navaratri day, Pratipat, we had a rebirth yesterday. Today we will have a rebirth. And what are we going to lose? What are we going to gain? We will see forward. That is the real significance of Navaratri. So new bright day, he finds in his life joys or sorrows, pleasures or pain, both are equally powerful to jolt the core of the man. These dualities, pleasure and pain, are the inevitable part of life. We can't escape from them. Nobody can escape from them. They are but valuable. They are very great lessons for us. They are our inner physicians. They are the doctors, inner physicians, serving our evolutionary process, the growth. They are serving, they are helping us to grow. As a force, they are identical, both pain and pleasure. When we go to the epicenter, we find their common point of origin, the emotional base within us, that is the heart, our heart. That's the emotional base. The wisdom lies in the efforts of paradigm shift. We have to make a paradigm shift now. From what we were thinking earlier, just destroying and just for our selfish ends. But if you properly harness that wonderful source of energy, you have to have a paradigm shift, then everything will change for good. So the emerging out of tamas, because of tamas, our slumber into the reality of divine love, we are causing all this pain, the suffering. Now this is the puja sankalpa. Now when we start the Durga Puja, it starts with sankalpa. So puja sankalpa, what is that sankalpa? So I will explain about that sankalpa in detail afterwards, but I will give you a small idea, because we are going to Durga Puja, we are now dealing about Navaratri and all the inner significance. Very, very important is, how can we connect that to the present day life? Without connecting that to our present day life, it may not be so meaningful. That's why connecting that to our life. So what is this sankalpa in the puja, in the Durga Puja? The resolution to worship the Divine Mother Durga. We shall try to schematically represent the whole Navaratris, the nine dark nights, their transcendence effect, and subsequent 9 days of blossoming of divinity. So there will be a paradigm shift from the earlier thought process of ours. After Navaratri, after doing worship to the mother, every day we will gain so many things, we will be losing so many things. So they tell, they do upavasa, that is, they fast on Navaratri. Many people are fasting on Navaratri. So I'm also fasting with the fruits and some juices or liquids. So now, or something like boiled vegetables. So, but what is real fasting? So here, all these 9 days, we have to give up something. First of all, you should know what is the meaning of upavasa. It is not just starvation. Upavasa in Sanskrit means to live near God. Upavasa, to live near God. So that is real upavasa. Now, what is the real fasting for Navaratri? What are we to give up? So if you go on giving these things, then you will be gaining so many good things. Let us see what is the real fasting for purification of our soul. First day, Pratipat, I will leave all my anger, which is the cause of tamas. It has come from tamas. I will leave all my anger. Second day, I will leave all my grudges, revengeful attitudes. Then the third day, I will stop judging people. I will stop finding fault and judging other people. Then the fourth day, I will forgive myself and everyone. Not only myself, I will forgive everyone. Then the fifth day, I will accept all, everyone as they are, and also accept myself as I am. Then the sixth day, I will love myself and everyone unconditionally. And the seventh day, I will leave all my feelings of jealousy and guilt. Eighth day, I will leave all my fears. I will become fearless. Ninth day, I will offer gratitude for all the things I have and all which I will get. Then, what is the victory day? Vijayadashmi, I am going to get. There is abundance in the universe for all. And I will always tap the same and create what I want through unconditional love, service, sadhana, nishkama seva, faith and devotion to God, service to God, meditation on Mother, Divine Mother. So, this is the way to celebrate Navaratri, to give up fasting, food, very good. But together with that, this is also important. We have to give up this, then we will see what we are going to gain every day. So, we shall also see what to give up now. So, first of all, I told that the tamas has to be given. Then, what all? Now we shall go to the next aspect of that. Navaratri, transcendence, effect and subsequent 9 days of blossoming of divinity. We shall see that. The natural tendencies and acquired tendencies in the jiva is the presence of which obscures its vision of reality. We have acquired through so many lives, so many years of this life, our earlier lives. So we have acquired so many tendencies. They are natural tendencies. And now we are also acquiring in future and now everything. So they are the acquired tendencies in a living being, the presence of which obscures its vision, all those desire, all those things, feelings in our heart, they obscure. The ajnana obscures the reality. They are called the nights of the jiva. They keep the jiva engrossed in worldly life. So now we shall see the central principle of Hindu religion in general and puja in particular is that through various procedures adopted in that puja, the sadhaka, that is the spiritual aspirant, rebuilds his personality in the mould of the object of worship. The Ishtadevata or the deity gets rid of the animal tendency in him, gets rid of the human nature in him completely and manifests his divine nature. That is the idea behind puja or religion or worship. So the divinity within him is to be manifested. He first identifies himself with the deity, with the supreme reality, and then accedes and approaches the deity as an immediately accessible manifestation of that reality. The sadhaka, the spiritual aspirant, understand that out of mercy and kindness, the divine, the supreme has manifested in and through the name and form or through an image. That's why in Vishishtadvaita Sampradaya, Ramanujacharya used to call the images as Archa Avatara. Avatara means coming down, the Lord comes down in flesh and blood as Avatara. Now, always you cannot get that Lord as Avatara. But you can get that in your own house as images. So Ramanujacharya used to tell that the images, the idols we worship is Archavatara. The Lord has taken that form of images and idols to receive our Archana, worship, puja. So they are Archavataras. So nothing to be worried about in Hinduism. The Lord has given this wonderful way of worshipping Him in the images and idols and made it so easy, which the other religions do not have. So we are so lucky to have the image worship and idol worship, which will make it so easy. So that is this Archavatara. So as to help the worshipper, out of his infinite kindness, he has taken a name, he has taken a form. So appropriate expression as desired by the sadhakas, what his likings, he He takes that form so as to help the worshipper to be able to love and adore him. It is as if God descending to be within human reach. That is the idol worship or image worship. So we have got the idea, significance of what is image worship, why we worship Mother Durga in the form of that idol. Okay. So one who strives to cross over tamas, I told the nine nights what we are going to give up. So I told anger is to be given up and other things. They are all the products of this tamas, ladaji. So the person who gives up tamas is called Brahmacharin. So all these days we have to follow the Brahmacharya Vrata. All of us. He is called a Brahmacharin. And the one who strives to cross over Rajas is called Sannyasin. So I will tell you again. One who strives to cross over Tamas, the lethargy, is called Brahmacharin. And the one who strives to cross over Rajas is called Sannyasin. There is the concept of Navaratri. This is the concept of Navaratri. A Jiva, a living being, is said to transcend the nine nights, darkness, defects, imperfections, before it attains the self-knowledge, the reunion with God. That is the significance of Navaratri. They are like the nine gates. After crossing each gate, each night, the sadhaka is said to attain a new light of a new day, a virtue, a merit, an illumination. The first night, the jiva has to pass over the tamas. Immediately, he is said to attain a day. What is that? The smriti, the constant remembrance of God. So I told you, if we leave all the 9 days real fasting, what are we going to gain? The first thing when you give up this tamas, constant remembrance of God, smriti, Bhagavan, smriti. The preceding table gives clear picture of the nine nights. A Brahmacharin is called Tamobhid. So on the first day, I explained it in the form of that nine shlokas and a table and other things because we cannot show it here in the picture. So, a Brahmacharin is called Tamobhid. He is expected to cross over the first three nights, Tamas, Dvesha, Mamakara. Then, through a life of renunciation dedicated to God, that is the life of Sannyasa, which is to be internalized in the case of householders. Then how can the, yes, Brahmacharya life everybody can live. How can the householders then take up Sannyasa? Once when a person posed a question to Holy Mother, Mother, Swami Vivekananda has told you will get liberation only through sannyasa. And Ramakrishna is telling that even the householders can have realization of God. So is it not contradicting each other? No. They are not contradictory. They are complementary, Holy Mother told. For the sannyasins, both external and internal sannyasa. For householders, it is not external sannyasa, but it is internal sannyasa. That was the reply of Holy Mother. So, the life of renunciation dedicated to God, the sannyasa, which is to be internalized in the case of the householders. Now, the next three nights, bhogeccha, ahankara, agnana, are to be crossed over. The intense desire to enjoy this world, the body, the flesh, that's called bhogeccha, ahankara, ego, egotism, agnana, ignorance, is to be crossed over. The last three nights, however, the Divine Mother alone can make the jiva crossover. Through giving oneself entirely, surrendering to Divine Mother through Sharanya. Sharanya is surrendering. One crosses over the three darkest nights. That's why there is puja, detailed puja is done only on the Saptami, Ashtami and Navami, the last 3 days during the Navaratri. And on the 10th day, Vijay Dashami, the Thiti Dashami, day there is a grand celebration. You have overcome all these troubles and problems and you have gained so many things. So there is a grand celebration of the day as the day of victory. Though symbolically and as a constant reminder of the 9 days of Navaratri are observed, the actual transcendence may take even a life or more. This is only symbolical, but this is how you can attain that in your life that is to be attained, that is given symbolically during Navaratri. So now we shall go to the, they only say the worshipper must find live a pious life. He should live a pious life. The worshipper, the sadhaka should live a pious life and undergo preliminary disciplines and attain competency. For example, one of the scriptures, Gandharva Tantra, describes competency as follows. The aspirant must be dexterous, be up and doing, daksha, with his senses under control, jitendriya, abstaining from injury to all beings, that is sarva himsa vinirmuktaha, sarva himsa vinirmuktaha, ever seeking and doing good to all, then sarva prani hite rataha, pure and clean in thought, word and action, shuchihi, acceptance in God, existence of God, astikaha, whose faith, proclaim, dedication and refuge are in Brahman, Brahmanishta, Brahmavadi, so Brahma Parayana, and is indifferent to or has placed all dualities at the feet of the Lord. Dvaitahina, such a one is competent in this scripture, otherwise he is no sadhaka. These are all the things which we have to develop during this Navaratri. Now, we have come to know something about Navaratri. Next time I am going to take up the Kalparamba, which is important. Now, we will go to the Durga Puja. In that Durga Puja, the first thing will be the Kalparamba. First, the Shashti day, sixth day, we will be doing Shashti Puja, Kalparamba, Divasa, Amantrana. So, we are going to the details and find out what is that Durga Puja, what is being done, why do we do that, what do we gain out of that. So, before that, I want to tell you a mantra which is very, very important, even in the Sankalpa Mantra and every time in the Puja that is used. I will just tell that mantra and then we will go to the next thing. I will explain to that in the next class. Now, what is that mantra? Divine Mother is worshipped with this mantra in the Durga Puja. What is that? Daksha Yagna Vinashinyai Maha Ghorayai Yogini Koti Parivratayai Bhadrakalyai Hrim Om Durgayai Namaha. This is the mantra. So we will take that and go into the detail in our next class. Now we will go to another aspect of the Navaratri, Durga Puja. What is that? In Navaratri, we also worship, we also invoke Mother in Navapatrika. What is this Navapatrika? That is 9 different types of trees or plants are tied together, and in that we invoke Divine Mother. Why do we do that in Durga Puja during Navaratri? What is the significance of this Navapatrika? So now, the tantras, the scriptures introduce practice of Vedantic truths in our daily life in a smooth and natural way. They say, the variety that you see in the universe is full of varieties. The variety that you see in the universe is nothing but different aspect of one great power, the Divine Mother. That is called Durga. The universe is nothing but the Divine Mother manifested in various ways. Even abstract things like pain and pleasure, action and reaction, sleep or strength, delusion or disease, or all are verily the Mother, that Mother. You are seeing with physical eyes. So, was it looking otherwise? So, was it looking otherwise? Now you develop spiritual eyes. You shall see with peace and joy, one existing as many. Still further, if you can yoke forth your heart to that one Divine Mother, you shall by her grace attain the everlasting peace and freedom. So now, in this Navapatrika Puja, what are we to learn? Why are they doing this special 9 plants have been wound together? The Navapatrika, what are those plants with the corresponding deities they represent? One, the first thing is Rambapala, plantain, or the banana plant. So the god is Brahmani, the goddess, sorry, deity is Brahmani. The second tree which is bound in that Navapatrika is Kaccha. Then the corresponding deity is Kalika. Then Haridra, Haridra means turmeric plant. Then for that, the Divine Mother is Durga. Then the third is Jayanti, plant Jayanti. So what is the deity there? Kartiki. Then it is a Bilva plant. You know Bilva. So the deity is Shiva, not Shiva, the Lord, male principle. It is Shiva, female principle of Shiva. So then it is Dadimba. What is Dadimba? Pomegranate plant is put there. So what is the deity there? Raktadantika. Then Ashoka plant is there, Ashoka tree. Then what is the deity there? Shokarahita is the deity. Then there is the tree called Manya. So what is the deity for that plant or the tree? Chamunda. Then the last one is rice plant. Dhanya, rice plant is wound there in that Navapatrika. What is the Divine Mother there? The deity Mahalakshmi. Now, Why do they tie these nine plants there for Namapatrika? The Namapatrika therein represents to the enchanting power of the universe. But for her divinity and her being the waking center of the Divine Mother, a woman is known to be the most enchanting power in the universe. Note it. A woman is known to be the most enchanting power in the universe for all humans everywhere. Through them, the Maya power, the power of Maya, Divine Mother, enchants, entices, entangles the living beings. Women themselves are enticed. Women themselves are enticed through the awareness of their own womanity. What then to speak of men who, in spite of their raised mustaches, are trapped in this Maya? Every jiva living being has to transcend this enchanting power of Divine Mother. The avidya maya, it's called avidya maya. By vidya maya, by knowledge, which keeps it away from God. That's why all this avidya, this attractions of the outer world, it takes our mind away from God. So all the living beings, men and women, must be able to see the Divine Mother. Men must be able to see the Divine Mother in every stage of the woman's life. So should women change their own awareness to become aware of themselves as divine being. I'll repeat that. This is very, very important. Men must be able to see the divine in woman at every stage of her life. So should women change their own awareness to become aware of themselves as divine beings. So now you can see the Navapatrika represents the Navadurga. Divine Mother Durga manifests as in the nine different forms. Navadurga are nine different stages of woman. What is this Navadurga? Why is this Navapatrika worshipped during the Navaratri or in the Durga Puja? So the Navadurga, nine different manifestation of Divine Mother, are nine different stages of woman's life. So in her life of the world, which are connected to the nine different divine forms of Mother. So I will state all of them and then I will stop my talk today, because almost I am at the end of the completion of that. I will conclude. So what are the Navadurgas? How is Divine Mother Durga manifesting her in nine different forms? So we have to worship in everywhere all over India. That different nine forms of Divine Mother Durga are worshipped every day. The first day of Navaratri, first Tithi Pratipat, we worship Shaila Putri. The second aspect of Divine Mother Durga on the second day of Navaratri is Brahmacharini. The third aspect manifestation of Divine Mother Durga is Chandra Ghanta. The fourth aspect is Kushmanda. So we worship Divine Mother Kushmanda on the fourth day of Navaratri. On the fifth day of Navaratri, we worship Skanda Mata, the mother of Skanda, Kartikeya, Subramanya. Then sixth day, we worship Katyayini. So Divine Mother came down as the daughter of one Rishi called Katyayana. So that's why she gets the name Katyayini. So on the sixth day, we worship her. Now the seventh day, the Divine Mother is worshipped as Kalaratri. Then the eighth day, the eighth manifestation of Divine Mother Durga is worshipped, that is Mahagauri. Then the ninth day, we worship the ninth manifestation of Divine Mother, that is called Siddhidatri. Now how to connect that? Now I told just earlier, that is the puja of Navadurga or this Navapatrika. So the Navadurga are nine different stages of woman in her life of the world, which are connected to the nine different forms of mother. So how are nine stages of a woman connected to the nine manifestation of Divine Mother Durga? Let us see it. What are they? So I told you earlier, we have to connect that men must be able to see the divine in woman at every stages of life. And women themselves should change their awareness to become aware of themselves as divine beings, Divine Mother Durga. They are the manifestation of Divine Mother Durga. So Navadurga or Navapatrika are nine different stages of woman in her life of the world, which are connected to the nine divine forms of mother. What are they? How shall we connect? Shaila Putri. What is the stage of the woman in the life? Infancy. Childhood. Infancy. So Shaila Putri is connected to that. So we should see the manifestation of Divine Mother. All the men and women should be aware of this manifestation of Divine Mother in infancy, woman's life. Secondly, Brahmacharini, girl under training, the educative life from the 7th age to her finishing of the education, that is Brahmacharini, girl under training. Then the third, so we have to see Divine Mother manifesting there as Brahmacharini. So it is not the girl there, the woman. That's why at that stage we do the Kumari worship also. I will be taking up that Kumari puja and I will be explaining about that. So what is the third manifestation and we worship on the third is Chandraghanta. What is that connected to? It is physically and mentally grown up and ready for a family life, who is ready to get married. That aspect of the woman's life is the manifestation of Chandraghanta, physically and mentally grown up and ready for a family life. So we have to see the Divine Mother Chandraghanta Durga there. Then the next is manifestation is Kushmanda. So how is it connected to woman's life? Woman on her family way, in her family way. After the marriage, she gets pregnant with the baby in her stomach womb. So that is Kushmanda. So that is a connection. So you have to see Mother Divine Mother Durga Kushmanda when the mother is pregnant with the baby. Then it is Kandamata. How is Kandamata connected to the different aspect of woman's life? Mother of a child. Skanda is Kartikeya. She is having that Kartikeya in her hands. So now the mother with the baby, life in the woman has to be seen as Kandamata and worship her. We have to treat her in that way. So then Katyayini, what is the aspect of Divine Mother Katyayini connecting to the woman's life? Mistress of a household. Now she is having children. She is looking after the husband and the children and the family life. So she is the mistress of the household. That is Katyayini. Then we have the next step, that is the Divine Mother manifestation, Kalaratri. So what is that Kalaratri? How is it connected to the Divine Mother and the woman's life here? Aged lady. Then we have the Mahagauri, the eighth manifestation of Durga. How is it connected to the life of the woman of enlightened wisdom, who has gained so much of wisdom, knowledge? So that is Mahagauri. So it is connected to the enlightened lady after so much of experience in the family life. Then the ninth manifestation of Siddhidatri. How is it connected to the woman's life? Blessing and seeking welfare of one and all, eye opener for the family and all others. That aspect of woman's life. Blessing and seeking welfare of one and all. So such a woman, eye opener for others. This aspect of the woman's life is representing Siddhidatri. So every stages of woman life, men have to see that Divine Mother manifested there now, Navadurga, and treat her like that. You should not hurt her. You should not ill-treat her. You should be serving the Divine Mother there. And also, not only men, women should also be aware of this aspect. They should not feel that they are ordinary body and this life is for the bhoga or just pleasures of the life. But Divine Mother manifested in them should be seen. So I will stop my discussion here.
करोति तमहरति भैरवी जगजननी जय जगवन्दिनि जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी धिम्धिमिधिम् भगवति नृत्य करोति तमहरति भैरवी जगजननी जय जगवन्दिनि जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी शिवानी काली कपालिनी परम शिवानी शरणागत परिपालिनी अभय प्रदायिनी अभय प्रदायिनी अमृत वर्षिणी अभय प्रदायिनी अमृत वर्षिणी अखिलांडेश्वरी अनंत रूपिणी विंधि विधि भगवती नृत्य करोति तम हरति भैरवी जग जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी राजेश्वरी महेश्वरी दया सागरी परम कृपा करी राजराजेश्वरी महेश्वरी अभयं करी अभयं करी करुणा करी अभयं करी करुणा करी ओंकार बीजाक्षरी दिंधिमिधि भगवती नृत्य जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी स्फूर्ति स्वरूपिणी कीर्तिदायिनी स्फूर्ति स्वरूपिणी कीर्तिदायिनी मंगलकारिणी मोक्ष प्रदायिनी स्फूर्ति स्वरूपिणी कीर्तिदायिनी मंगलकारिणी मोक्ष प्रदायिनी महिषमर्दिनी महिषमर्दिनी महेश प्रियकरी महिषमर्दिनी महेश प्रियकरी दुर्गा भवानी मंगल गौरी दिंधि मिधि भगवती नृत्य करोति तम हरति भैरवी जग जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी आदिशक्ति पर ब्रह्मस्वरूपिणी आदिशक्ति पर ब्रह्मस्वरूपिणी सिंहवाहिनी त्रिलोकपालिनी आदिशक्ति पर ब्रह्मस्वरूपिणी सिंहवाहिनी त्रिलोकपालिनी पन्नगशयन प्रिय सहोदरी पन्नगशयन प्रिय सहोदरी पाहि मां जननी माता दयावति दिंधि मिधि भगवती नृत्य करोति तम हरति भैरवी जग जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी ढिं ढिं धिमिढि धमरुगदिनाद ढिं ढिं धिमिढि धमरुगदिनाद जय 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 ओंकार रूपिणी ढिं ढिं धिमिढि धमरुगदिनाद जय नृत्य करोति तम हरति भैरवी जग जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी जग जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी भवानी जग जननी जय जगवंदिनी जगदोद्धारिणी